It almost looks like a magic spell, a swirling, twirling, giant storm that's headed right for shore. What's up, weather wizards? Are you ready to learn about hurricanes? Mother Nature cooks up this combination of fierce winds and torrential rains to make something like a huge stormy whirlpool right up in the sky. But don't worry, we've got the scoop to help you understand what makes them tick and how to stay safe when they come knocking on our door. Hurricanes may be destructive, but it's their very power that makes them a natural wonder. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. Hurricanes are massive storms that form over warm ocean waters. They're like giant swirling wind machines with heavy rain added for bonus excitement. What makes hurricanes different from other storms like thunderstorms or tornadoes is their size and strength. Hurricanes can be hundreds of miles wide and last for days. Other storms are usually smaller and don't last as long. Depending on where you live, you may know hurricanes by a different name. In the Atlantic and the Northeast Pacific, they're called hurricanes. In the Northwest Pacific, they're called typhoons. And in the South Pacific and Indian Ocean, they're called cyclones. Who knew? Hurricanes have a unique look that make them easy to recognize. They look a lot like a spiral galaxy. In the middle of the giant spiral-shaped storm, there's a clear center called the eye. The eye is usually calm and peaceful, surrounded by a ring of thick clouds called the eye wall. Outside the eye wall, there are bands of clouds that spiral outward, bringing heavy rain and strong winds. These bands can stretch for hundreds of miles, covering large areas. When you see these swirling clouds and feel strong winds and heavy rain, you know a hurricane is nearby. Also, keep an eye on weather reports and listen for warnings from officials. They'll help you recognize when a hurricane is headed your way. But how do these hurricanes start? Hurricanes happen when warm ocean water heats up the air above it. This warm, moist air rises, creating an area of low pressure beneath it. More warm air rushes in to fill the low pressure area, and as it rises and cools, it forms clouds. As the process continues, the rotation of the Earth causes the storm to spin. This spinning motion, combined with the heat and moisture from the ocean, makes the hurricane grow stronger. And there it is, a full-on hurricane. Hurricanes end when they move over cooler waters or hit land. Without warm water to fuel them from below, hurricanes lose their energy and weaken. However, even as hurricanes weaken, they can still bring heavy rain, strong winds, and flooding to areas they pass over. Want to take home a souvenir? Visit our website for smart, fun posters that are funny and fact-filled. Find the link below. The winds in a hurricane can blow really, really fast. We're talking about speeds that can make your hair stand on end. In fact, hurricanes are categorized by how strong their winds are. The fastest hurricanes, like the ones you might hear about on the news, can have winds that blast at over 150 miles per hour, or 240 kilometers per hour. That's like a supercharged race car zooming down the highway. These powerful winds can uproot trees, tear off roofs, and even flip over cars. So when a hurricane is coming your way, it's important to stay safe and listen to the experts. Speaking of experts, scientists use a surprising variety of tools to predict how big a hurricane will get and how long it will last. One tool they use isn't even on the planet. Satellites in space. Satellites orbit the Earth and can take pictures from space, giving scientists a view of hurricanes as they form and grow. Back on Earth, well, actually on the ocean, they also use tools called weather buoys. These are like mini weather stations that take measurements of things like air temperature and pressure. Now, here's the real doozy. Would you believe they even use planes to fly right into hurricanes? Talk about going right to the heart of the problem. This allows scientists to gather information about the hurricane's size, wind speed, and direction. Add all this information together and scientists start to get a good idea about how the hurricane will develop. Some scientists predict that a hurricane is going to be really big and dangerous, but then it ends up not being as bad as they think. This can happen because hurricanes are really complicated and hard to predict perfectly. They're influenced by lots of things that are all changing every second. So even though scientists use all kinds of tools to make predictions, sometimes hurricanes can surprise us by weakening or changing direction at the last minute. It's kind of like when you think it's going to rain all day, but then the sun comes out instead. While it's good news when a hurricane isn't as strong as predicted, it's still important to take precautions and stay safe, just in case. Staying safe during a hurricane is super important. First off, listen to the experts. Pay attention to weather forecasts and follow any evacuation orders from local officials. If you're told to evacuate, do it right away. If you can't leave, find a safe place to stay indoors, away from windows and doors. It's also smart to prepare an emergency kit with things like water, food, flashlights, and a first aid kit. Make sure your family knows where to meet up if you get separated. Also, during the storm, stay indoors and don't go outside until it's completely over. Watch out for flooding, which can happen even after the rain stops. And remember, never touch downed power lines or go near flooded areas. They can be really dangerous. Now that we know more about hurricanes, it's time to get on a first name basis with them. Did you know that hurricanes have first names? Like Hurricane Michael? Or Hurricane Cindy? Hurricanes get their names from lists created by organizations like the World Meteorological Organization. Each year, there are different lists of names for hurricanes in different regions. The names are usually chosen from a list of common names used in that region. For example, in the Atlantic Ocean, there are lists of names that alternate between boy and girl names. This helps people easily identify and remember different hurricanes as they come and go. Some hurricanes are so big and powerful that they become famous. One example is Hurricane Katrina, which hit the United States in 2005. It was one of the worst hurricanes in US history, causing widespread destruction and flooding in New Orleans and other parts of Louisiana and Mississippi. Another famous hurricane is Hurricane Sandy, which struck the east coast of the United States in 2012. It caused massive damage and flooding in New York City and New Jersey. You may have noticed that some places seem to have terrible luck when it comes to hurricanes. It's not bad luck. Really, it's just that there are certain parts of the world where hurricanes are naturally more likely to occur. In general, hurricanes are more common in regions with warm ocean waters, like the tropical Atlantic Ocean, the Eastern Pacific Ocean, and the Western Pacific Ocean near Asia. Also, places near the equator, where the ocean water is warmest, tend to see more hurricanes. That's why countries like the United States, Mexico, and the Caribbean islands often experience hurricanes during certain times of the year when the weather conditions are right. For instance, in Florida, the official hurricane season is June through November, but more than 96% of hurricanes there happen from August to October. You weren't planning a trip then, were you? So, there you have it, weather explorers. From their formation over warm ocean waters to their potential impact on land, we know we have to keep a close eye on hurricanes. By understanding how hurricanes form, recognizing their signs, and knowing how to stay safe, we can better prepare ourselves for when these mighty storms come our way. Remember, whether it's stocking up on supplies or listening to evacuation orders, being prepared and staying informed are key to weathering the storm. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.